I've asked myself the same question again and again. What is man? And what is his final state? Is he a product or a creator? I think he is both. And what is art? It's part of the human soul, expressed in letters, sounds, colors, motions, lines, and forms. Each man is unique in his joys, suffering, hypocrisy, deceit, and love. The single being, who wanders theatrically in the darkness of the universe with a small candle, suffers, loves, and dies. Without believing in suffering, love, or death. A strange being, isn't it? And you know, this is you and us, who always ennoble and glorify others, the same as we do, but with the great inspiration that forms us, tells us what is right and wrong, tells us truth from lies, our conception of beauty and ugliness. Look at the people's faces. There is no beauty or ugliness there, but only originality. I think art is also originality. And this proves that art belongs to us, creators. It is our human creation. We write philosophy, create religions and beliefs that give birth to tyrants, and kill ourselves only to be original. And we can't stand the negation of our uniqueness over the course of time. Why do we do it? We form fabrics of influence, and passing through them, the human being takes on a necessarily wise character, which is called the man of today. We do the same thing with art. We form ourselves, our souls, in the same way we create art, which is remarkably rich in its forms, ideas, and varieties of expression. The man is just like his creation, only made of different layers. And let us imagine for a moment a time when the conception of man and art didn't yet exist. Let us imagine that all the fabrics that form people and art had long ago become memories in the consciousness of a future generation. So what kind of generation would it be? I think an idea will appear of the human being's hyper-originality, the creator of absolute freedom and absolute art, though it won't be without paradox, absolute contradictions. And imagine what kind of art there will be then. It will be independent of the creator's will. Art will be a soulful creation, a true creation, living its isolated and independent life.